So I really see extraordinary future opportunities for Taiwan that build on the existing leadership in semiconductors and in computing, and bring these new tools to bear to create a future where AI will be not energy hungry the way Eric suggested. AI will be manageable, AI will be private, and AI will be capable and will be able to support all of us.
In the past 20 years, our special guest really has spent brief time on the one hand to advance the importance of automation, 机器人, on the other hand, make sure it has produced good benefits to the mankind. Dr. Ruth's latest book was translated into Chinese. Very readable and very enjoyable to read.
We have to be careful because, you know, the way I see it, AI and robotics are empowering us with superpowers on the cognitive side and on the physical side. Here's what I want to say. While the last 60 years has been all about building constrained hard robots with industrial applications, the next today and the next 60 years will be about adaptive soft robots that are pervasive and come with a diversity of shapes. Taiwan has really unique strengths in computing and in AI. In particular, Taiwan has been very visionary, has been partnering with a lot of universities and a lot of visionary institutions across the world. So Taiwan has extraordinary semiconductor leadership through world-class foundries, through packaging and memory integration, through close feedback loop between model needs and silicon roadmaps. Taiwan also has an edge AI ecosystem, and it has the ability to consider connectivity as part of a comprehensive solution. We really have many business opportunities for the future in Taiwan, and in particular, edge AI is a growing need for AI. AI that is energy efficient, that can run on device, that can run on-prem, that does not require the cloud calls, that allows you to keep everything you do with AI private. There are so many interesting opportunities ahead of us that, that we can innovate and that we can imagine to make a better world and a better future for everyone. But as we think about this better world and better future, it's important to think about humankind, about ourselves, about our future generations, and also about our neighbors on this planet, because we're all so interconnected.